Hey everyone, my name's Mr. Redjeb. I'm a teacher from Holy Trinity School. I've decided to put together a set of creative writing lessons to help out people who are being homeschooled at the moment. We live in uncertain times, so hopefully these lessons will help out and provide some entertainment. Writing's one of my passions, so this is why I want to share my love for writing with you. All you're going to need for this lesson is a notepad, a pen or a pencil, something to write with, something to write on, and we're going to learn how to write a Cinquain poem. What I like to do first in my class, before I start writing, is take part in something called Superhero Spag. These are some questions that are going to test your English knowledge. Okay, so our first question's like this. We're looking for a verb, the word in red, to fit into this sentence here. The flash was something quickly. And we've got some options down here. Speedy, slowly, running, or under. Shout out now which verb you think would fit into that sentence. So I've chosen running as the verb there. It's a doing word. You can see it by the ing ending. So I've added that into the sentence and we can see it makes sense. The flash was running quickly. So the next thing we're looking for is two adjectives. The Hulk has something skin and is something. Again, I've got some options at the bottom. Weak, green, red, or strong. Look at the picture to help you. Shout out now which adjectives would fit into that sentence. So we can see I've chosen green skin, and that he is strong. An adjective is a word that describes a noun. So our noun is the Hulk. We're describing his green skin and the fact that he's a strong character. Okay, now we're looking for an adverb. An adverb is a word that describes a verb, so it's describing how an action is done. So let's have a look. Iron Man sprang into action something. So we've got some options. Quickly, in time, to save the day, or and won the fight. Which one of those words is an adverb? Shout it out now. So I filled it in with quickly. That's my adverb. An adverb you can usually spot as an ly ending. So Iron Man sprang into action quickly. So the next thing we're looking for is positional language. If you don't know what this is, the clue really is in the name, position, where something's placed. So Spider-Man was something, the building. Take a look at the picture, and then let's have a look at the options. Beside, next to, on top of, or under. So if you looked carefully at the picture, you'd see that Spider-Man was on top of the building. So the last thing we're looking for is we're going to place some brackets within the sentence. Think for a moment, what are brackets placed around in a sentence? If you said extra information, you're right. So let's have a look at the sentence and see if we can spot the extra information. Wonder Woman, Diana Prince, is a superhero. So you can see I've added the brackets in red here. The extra information is Diana Prince. That's Wonder Woman's secret identity, if you didn't know. And it could be removed from the sentence and it would still make sense. But for the moment, it's giving our reader a bit of extra information. Wonder Woman, Diana Prince, is a superhero. Well done to all of you having a good go at Superhero Spag. I hope you enjoyed that little starter activity. We'll keep it up together and get a bit faster, a bit harder questions too. For today's lesson, I'm going to pick up where I left with my Year 5 class at Holy Trinity, and that's with learning about a Cinquain poem. You might not have ever heard of this before, but together we're going to look through how to structure a Cinquain poem and then eventually how to write our own. I'm going to show you three different examples of the Cinquain poem: Watermelon, Unicorn, and Rain. In a moment, I'm going to ask you to pause the video and read each of these. Try to pick out some of the features, look at how they're structured, and look at the words that are chosen in each poem. Is there anything specific about each one? Have a look and think carefully. In a moment, we're going to go through what makes up a Cinquain poem. Hopefully you enjoyed reading those Cinquain poems and have spotted a few things. Firstly, we're going to look at the structure. As you can see, it's one word, two words, three words, four words, and then one word. But we need to think carefully about which type of word fits on each line. There are very specific rules for a Cinquain that we need to follow. Let's have a look at the first line first, the one word. The first line is a single noun. Just take a moment to remind yourself what a noun is. Call it out. See if you've got the same definition as me.
This is my definition. A word or phrase that is the name of something, a person, a place, or a thing. For example, for a cinquain, you could use mum, England, or rain cloud, along with lots of other nouns. These are just the three I've chosen. Mum is a person, England, a place, rain cloud, a thing. You choose one of these and write just that one word on the first line. So I've chosen rain cloud as my topic, and I've added that into my first line. My first word is a noun, rain cloud. Now I'm going to look at the second line. Two words, they're going to be two adjectives. As I said, the second line is two adjectives. Think for a moment, what is an adjective? What does it do? Be ready to shout out your definition. Mine is words that are used to help describe or give description to people, places, or things. So they're going to describe a noun. I wonder if you could think of any examples of adjectives that could describe a rain cloud. They could be simple, they could be ambitious adjectives. Start with the basics first and see if you can think of something more complicated later. These are the examples I came up with. Gloomy, stormy, grey, thick, and dark. We only need two, so I'm just going to choose two that I like the most and add them to my Cinquain poem. So there we are. I've added grey and gloomy. Two words, two adjectives. So far our poem goes rain cloud, grey, gloomy. Now on to the third line. Three words. These are going to be three verbs. So as I say, the third line is three verbs. We've seen a verb in Superior's bag. Think about what a verb is. Be ready with your definition. Mine is words that show actions, motions, or doing. They usually have an ing on the end. Verbs for a rain cloud might be a bit tricky, but think of actions a rain cloud does. These are some of the ones I came up with. Falling, dripping, pelting, soaking, descending. Words are describing either the rain clouds, rain falling, or what happens is soaking people down on the road. Again, I only need three, so I'm going to choose the three I like best to add to our poem. So I'm going to add in my three verbs, falling, dripping, pelting. So far, our poem goes rain cloud, grey, gloomy, falling, dripping, pelting. Three words, three verbs. Now we're on to the fourth line. It's four words, and it's a little bit different from the other lines so far. The fourth line is four words, but they don't necessarily follow a rule. The four words describe an action that the object, the place, or the person does. So it doesn't necessarily need to be a verb or an adjective. For example, if we looked back at the rain poem at the start, we could see they described the rain as hammering on the roof. The one I've come up with is gazing from up above. I wonder if you know what type of technique gazing from up above is. If you said personification, you're correct. A rain cloud doesn't really gaze down. It doesn't look down like a person does, but I've given it that bit of extra human life, gazing from up above, and I'm going to choose that line to add into my poem. So there we go. I'm going to put gazing from up above into my poem. So now I've got rain cloud, grey, gloomy, falling, dripping, pelting, gazing from up above. Our fourth line, four words, describing an action. Now on to the final line. We've almost finished a cinquain together. The fifth line is a single synonym. I wonder if you know what the word synonym means. Be ready to shout it out. Synonym are words with the same or similar meaning. So, we only need one synonym, another word that might mean the same as your noun from the first line. I've got to think of another word that has a similar meaning to rain cloud. Let's see what I've come up with. So I've added in my synonym, storm. One word, a synonym of the first noun. I've got my whole cinquain together now. I'll read it to you. Rain cloud, grey, gloomy. Falling, dripping, pelting. Gazing from up above. Storm. It's quite effective, isn't it? Just a few word choices, no extended writing needed, and you've already got an effective poem written. But how do you go about starting your own? Well, I've got a bit of a tip for you there. I'm going to give you a bit of an example of how to start here, and then perhaps you can have a go at doing this on your own. Have a look at this picture of the tiger. Imagine this is the title of our poem and the first line. Our noun for the first line is tiger. We need some of the most effective adjectives, or as my class know, I like to call them ambitious adjectives, and verbs to describe the animal. Look closely at the picture. Study some of the features that you could describe. I'm going to give you 30 seconds. During that time, you need to write down as many adjectives or verbs as you can. Don't worry about the quality of them just yet. We've got a moment to think about that later. Just as many as you can in 30 seconds. Then I'm going to share some of the words I came up with in 30 seconds too, just to give you a bit of help. I'm about to give you a 30-second timer, so make sure you've got a pencil and a notepad or something to write with in front of you, ready to write down your words. 3, 2, 1. Seconds goes quite quickly, doesn't it? But hopefully you managed to write down some words. Like I say, don't worry if they're not the most ambitious yet. You'll find with more practice, you can come up with better words more quickly. These are the ones I came up with though. These are my adjectives, first of all. Feral, wild, untamed, predator, sharp, camouflaged, ravenous. You could describe specific things about the tiger, like sharp links to its teeth. These are my verbs. Hunting, prowling, roaring, growling, devouring, sneaking. Now, I've got quite a list of adjectives and verbs, but I know I only need 2 adjectives and I only need 3 verbs. This is where you can start to think of some more ambitious words, or you can just choose your best. Choose 2 adjectives you like the best and star them. Choose 3 verbs you like the best and star them. As we're working together on this tiger, Cinquain, you could choose some of mine. I'll let you borrow those. So you might have chosen some of your own adjectives and verbs to describe the tiger, or you may have used some of mine. Either is fine for this first time we're doing this Cinquain poem. These are the ones I've chosen. Wild and ravenous for adjectives, and then for verbs I've chosen hunting, roaring and sneaking. Think about which way round you want to put the words. Think about, especially with the verbs, perhaps telling a small story. You'll see what I mean in a moment. I've finished my Cinquain poem. I'll read it out to you. Tiger, wild, ravenous, sneaking, hunting, roaring, teeth like sharp knives, predator. You can see I've followed the pattern. 1 word, a noun. 2 words, 2 adjectives. 3 words, 3 verbs. 4 words describing an action, and 1 word, a synonym of the first noun. Now, you noticed I moved some of the verbs around, sneaking, hunting, roaring. I just thought this painted an image of the tiger sneaking up, it's hunting its prey, and then when it sees its prey, it roars really loudly. You'll also notice on the fourth line, I've used a different technique that we haven't looked at today. Have a think. Check the words. There's 1 word that will give away the technique I've used there. Did you get it? I used a simile. Teeth like sharp knives. A simile is when you use the word like or as to compare 2 things that are similar. I've compared the tiger's teeth to sharp knives because of how deadly they are. You might want to challenge yourself to try and use a simile on the fourth line or personification like I used before. But it's up to you. Don't feel you have to when you're first learning how to write Cinquain. This is something you can do once you're better and have had a bit of practice. We've looked at 2 Cinquains together. We've looked at my rain cloud example, and then we looked at writing a tiger example together. But now it's your turn. Firstly, find a subject that inspires you. I find it helps to have a picture of this or to be able to see it. Look on an iPad maybe, or choose something that you can see around the house, maybe in the garden. The weather's been really nice recently, so you could sit outside to write and then you can see your subject. Use the 30-second timer activity to write down as many adjectives and verbs to describe the subject as you can. Then, pick your two best adjectives. Try to make them ambitious. You might find this is easier once you've practiced. And then three of your best descriptive verbs. Put your Cinquain poem together using the structure guide here. One word, a noun. Two words, two adjectives. Three words, three verbs. Four words that describe an action. One word, a synonym of the first noun. Cinquains are quite short, so you might want to have a go at writing more than one. I leave that up to you now. You can choose the subject. You choose what you want to write about. Have fun.
I hope you enjoyed that short lesson today, learning how to write Cinquain. Hopefully you learned something new and you're going to enjoy writing those poems independently. If you've got an adult with you, once you've written your Cinquain poem, you might want to get their help to comment down below your poem so I can read it in the comment section. I hope you all stay safe and I'll catch you soon.